boys and girls. Today we're going to read Ready Freddy, The Penguin Problem by Abby Klein, illustrated by John McKinley. Now, I don't know if you guys remember this. When John McKinley draws the pictures, he likes to hide a word inside of every one of his illustrations. That word is fin, because Freddy loves sharks and sharks have fins. So we can find the word F-I-N in every picture. Let me show you what I mean. Okay, I'm gonna have to zoom in here a little bit. Look right here at her shirt. See how it says F-I-N? You have to look really closely. It's hidden really well sometimes. Sometimes it's really hard to find. But it's fun. So when I show you the pictures, you can pause the camera and you can zoom in and see if you can find it. Okay. I'll try to remember to remind you. Okay. So chapters. 1. Penguins, penguins, penguins. 2. Playing penguin. 3. Blubber. 4. Endangered animals. 5. Ideas, anyone? 6. The vote. 7. Penny problems. 8. Pennies for penguins. And Freddy's fun pages. Yeah. I have a problem. A really, really big problem. My class is doing a penny drive to raise money so we can adopt an endangered species of penguin. But I lost my penny collection. Let me tell you about it. Chapter 1, Penguins, Penguins, Penguins. Okay, boys and girls, said my teacher, Mrs. Wooshy. Now that we have read a lot about penguins, let's see if we can make a chart of some of the things we have learned. Ooh, 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 I know, Chloe squealed as she waved her hand wildly in the air. Hey, watch it, Max snapped. You're going to poke me in the eye.
I am not, said Chloe.
Yes, you are, little fancy pants.
Oh, no, I'm not.
All right, enough, you two, said Mrs. Wooshy. Max, please come sit over here. She pointed to a place on the rug right next to her.
But she's the one who almost hit me.
Well, then this spot will be perfect for you. Chloe won't be able to reach you here, so you won't have to worry about being bumped by accident.
But,
Max, I'm not asking you. I'm telling you, said Mrs. Wooshy. Let's go.
It's not fair,
Max mumbled under his breath, and then he slowly got up and moved over next to the teacher. Now, where were we? Asked Mrs. Wooshy. You were asking us what we learned about penguins, said Jessie. Thank you, Jessie, said Mrs. Wooshy. Chloe waved her hand wildly again. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Chloe, you need to raise your hand quietly and wait to be called on. I'm going to call on someone with a quiet hand. Robbie, my best friend, who is a walking encyclopedia, was sitting quietly with his hand raised. Robbie, said Mrs. Wooshy, what have you learned about penguins? Penguins live in the southern hemisphere in places like Antarctica, South Africa, and New Zealand. Excellent, Robbie. You are absolutely right. Penguins live on the bottom half of the earth. Mrs. Wooshy wrote Robbie's fact on the chart. You are such a brain, I whispered to Robbie. I think you're the smartest person I know. Robbie smiled. Thanks. Chloe was still ooh-ooh-ooing, so Mrs. Wooshy called on Jessie next. Jessie? Penguins are really good swimmers, but they can't breathe underwater. That's right, Jessie. Penguins don't have gills like fish. They have lungs, so they have to come to the surface of the water to breathe air. I will write that on the chart. Chloe had finally stopped squealing, so Mrs. Wooshy called on her.
Penguins eat fish, krill, or squid, Chloe said.
That sounds so disgusting to me. I'm glad I'm not a penguin. She twirled her curls around her finger. And remember, said Mrs. Wooshy, we read that they swallow their food whole.
Cool, said Max. I once tried to swallow a hot dog whole, but it didn't work.
No kidding, Jessie whispered to me. Mrs. Wooshy ignored Max and continued, who else has a fact about penguins? How about you, Freddy? Leopard seals eat penguins. Good. The leopard seal is the penguin's main predator. They are very big and have very sharp teeth. They have to eat about 4 to 5 penguins a day to stay alive. How sad, said Jessie. How can they eat something so cute? It's just part of the food chain, said Mrs. Wooshy. They are hungry and they need to eat to stay warm. Let's see, who hasn't said anything yet? Max, how about you?
I wasn't raising my hand.
I know, said Mrs. Wooshy, but I'd like everyone to come up with something for the chart.
Oh, I know, he said. Penguins lay eggs.
Do you remember how many eggs a penguin lays at a time? Max stammered. Two eggs, Chloe interrupted. Penguins lay two eggs.
Be quiet, yelled Max. It's not your turn. It's my turn.
But you didn't know the answer, Chloe said.
Oh, yes, I did.
No, you didn't, or else you would have said it.
Max and Chloe, said Mrs. Wooshy, you both need to stop this right now. No more arguing. Chloe, you interrupted Max, and that is not polite.
Yeah,
said Max.
But he was taking forever, Chloe said.
You had your turn, said Mrs. Wooshy. You need to let other people have their turn.
I don't think she knows how to take turns, Jessie whispered to me.
If you can't do that, Mrs. Wooshy continued, then you will have to sit in the timeout chair.
Just put her there right now, Max mumbled.
And Max, you need to leave her alone or else you will also get a visit to the timeout chair.
Fine,
Max said, shrugging. Robbie raised his hand. All penguins lay two eggs except the emperor and king penguins. They lay only one, he added. That is correct. Most penguins lay two eggs except for the ones that Robbie just mentioned. And, said Jessie.
Yes, said Mrs. Wooshy. The mom and the dad take turns keeping the egg warm.
Right. Since it is so cold where the penguins live, the chick inside the egg would die if the egg was left uncovered for as little as 5 minutes. So the mom and dad can't leave the nest at the same time. If the mom goes to get food, then the dad sits on the eggs. When the mom comes back, then it's the dad's turn to look for food. Sometimes one of them can be gone for as long as 2 weeks.
2 weeks, said Max. I can't go without food for 2 hours.
No kidding, I whispered to Robbie.
Robbie giggled. Penguins need to eat to stay warm. There is also something else that keeps them warm, said Mrs. Wooshy. Does anyone know what that is? Before anyone could answer, the bell rang for recess.
Oh my goodness, it's time for recess already. We will have to continue this when we come back inside.
Chapter 2, Playing Penguin. We all ran outside for recess. Let's play penguin, said Jessie.
That's a good idea, I said.
I want to play, said Robbie.
We can all play together, I said.
What should we do?
I know, said Jessie.
We can pretend that the play structure is an ice floe and the sand is water. If you were in the sand, you'd better swim fast or else the leopard seals might eat you.
And we can make a nest out of pebbles over there on the grass, just like the one kind of penguin Mrs. Wooshy was telling us about, I said.
The Adelaide penguin make their nests out of pebbles, said Robbie.
Thanks, super scientist, I said, laughing.
I think there are a bunch of pebbles over by those trees, said Jessie, pointing to a spot across the playground.
Then let's go, I said.
But what are we waiting for?
I started to run, but Jessie grabbed me.
What?
Hello? You're a penguin?
I know.
Well, penguins don't run. They waddle, said Jessie.
Right, I said, laughing. We put our arms by our sides, and the three of us started to waddle across the playground.
Don't forget to look for the word fin.
As I was waddling across the yard, Max ran right into me, sending me sailing to the pavement. I hit the ground hard.
Oof!
Freddy, are you all right? Asked Robbie.
Hey, shark breath, watch where you're going, yelled Max.
He ran into me, I said to Robbie.
What did you say?
Asked Max, bending down so his face was close to mine. Talk about shark breath.
Nothing, I said quietly.
He said you ran into him, said Jessie.
Boy, Jessie was so brave. She was the only one brave enough to stand up to Max, the biggest bully in the whole first grade.
And I think that you should say you're sorry, she added.
Max stared at her for a minute and then started to walk away, but Jessie grabbed him.
Take your hands off me, shouted Max.
Not until you tell Freddy you're sorry.
It's okay, I said to Jessie. No, it's not. Max hurt you and he needs to say he's sorry. Max tried to squirm free, but Jessie held him tight. She was strong.
We're waiting, said Jessie, staring at Max.
Sorry,
Max grunted and then ran off. Are you okay? Robbie asked.
I think so, I said, pulling up my pant leg to look at my knee. I don't see any blood, said Robbie. I think I'll be okay, I said. Here, let me help you up, said Robbie. I stood up and brushed myself off. Let's go, penguin friends, Jesse said, laughing. Let's go get the pebbles for our nest. We waddled over to the line of trees and started to pick up pebbles. Ooh, look at this one, said Jesse. It's so smooth and shiny. I found a bunch of good ones, I said, shoving them into my pocket. You know the Adelaide penguins use over 100 pebbles to make their nest, said Robbie. 100? We'll never get that many, I said. Well, we could start building it now. And then work on it some more at lunch recess, said Jesse. Good idea, Robbie, and I said. We took the pebbles we had collected so far and carried them over to the grass. Their nest is like a huge circle, said Robbie. The boy penguins usually make the nest while the girls go eat, said Jesse. So I'm going to go catch some fish while you guys lay the pebbles out in a big circle. Don't get caught by the leopard seal, I called after her. I won't. As Jesse ran over to the sandbox, Robbie and I started to lay the pebbles on the ground. How many do you think we have? I asked Robbie. I don't know, maybe 20. We started to count them, and then we heard Jesse yell, help me, help me, I'm being chased by a leopard seal. Don't worry, we'll save you, Robbie and I yelled. The two of us waddled over to the sandbox and started swimming as fast as we could. Jump onto that ice floe, jump onto that ice floe, we shouted to Jesse. Jesse jumped onto the play structure and we followed her up there. Whew, that was a close one, said Jesse. Thanks for saving me. What are friends for? I said, smiling. Good thing you're a fast swimmer. That leopard seal looked really hungry. We'd better get back to building the nest or it won't be ready for the eggs, said Robbie. Before we get back in the water, we'd better look for that leopard seal or we might all get eaten. I looked over the edge of the play structure into the sand. It looks like the coast is clear. Come on. We jumped into the water, swam to land, and then waddled back to the nest. We didn't get to put out all the pebbles yet, said Robbie, because we had to come save you. That's okay, said Jesse. I'll help you with the rest. We laid out the rest of the pebbles and then stood back to take a look. We're going to need a lot more, said Robbie. This is a big job, I said. I wonder how the penguins do it. They must get really tired. It is a lot of work, said Robbie, and they have to do it every year. I didn't even know that there were rocks in Antarctica, said Jesse. Me either, I said. I thought it was just a bunch of ice. It's volcanic rock, said Robbie. It was formed a long time ago when volcanoes erupted there. Is there anything you don't know? I said to Robbie. He smiled. Come on, guys, said Jesse. Recess is almost. Before she could even say the word over, the bell rang, signaling the end of recess. Bummer, I said. I was having so much fun. Me too, said Robbie. Don't worry, we can play again at lunch recess, said Jesse. Now we'd better hurry up or we'll be late getting into line. Last one there is a rotten egg, I yelled as I took off waddling across the playground.